Good evening, friends. Just down here at the barn, spending some time alone and in my thoughts, which a lot of you know I do that kind of regularly. I guess I'm an oddball, no doubt. And being an oddball kind of put me in the place of being an underdog a lot in my life. And hopefully the things I share tonight might help somebody out there that's feeling like they might be a little bit of an underdog. And I'm not doing this video to whine or boob, I can probably promise you that. But to hopefully inspire somebody. From the time I was just a kid, and those of you who know, I was really close to my father, and we had a very lucrative ranch, and it was doing really well. Unfortunately, he passed away when I was 11, and we lost everything, and took my first job on a ranch away from home when I was 12. Things went to changing, for sure. And because of events from my youth, I became what some would call an underdog, I guess. And I haven't always made the best choices in my life. Obviously, still don't. But the people who were in authority, whether that was in the education system or in the church community, they got to looking down their nose at me pretty bad and shunning me and casting stones, if you will. A lot of stone casting. For a young boy who just lost his dad and was pretty lost, I had a lot of granite knocked my way. But you know what? I don't regret it. It made me who I am. But, from church leaders to a lot in the education system, principals, teachers, counselors, vice principals, had I followed their plan for me, I'd be in prison right now. They even told my sweet little mother that I'd be in prison by the time I was 19 years old. You know how many nights I've spent in jail? Not one. Not ever. Have I done some things in my youth that were less than appropriate? Yeah. Those of you who know me from back then, I was a hard drinking man, a dang sure fighter, and raised a lot of hell. Praise God that that's all long, long, long gone behind me. But I was told ever since I was a young boy, I was going to be just a worthless rodeo bum. The cowboys never amount to nothing. You're just a rodeo bum. You're just going to end up in prison. I've heard that. It would shock you if you knew. and not just from people in authority, but even other family members and members of families from gals that day and had relationships with, that I was a nobody. So, and even to this very day, there's people who doubt me, and that's fine. And I'm not doing this video, like I said, I'm not doing it to whine. And I'm certainly not doing it to brag. But through all of those trials and tribulations, and the years I spent running with the devil and trying to scare the hell out of him, God had plans for me. paying attention to what his plans are for me. God knows, and that's all we need to know, folks. Anyway, like I say, being an underdog can drag you down. And for anybody who is out there that is being told they're not good enough, they can't. They ain't got a chance. I don't care if it's in a career, in a sport. Maybe you're a songwriter. Maybe a sculptor. Maybe you want to be a professional skateboarder. Heck, I don't know, whatever it is. If it's on your heart, God put it there. That's God's design. He made you with certain desires and certain talents. And he didn't give those things to you for no good reason. I promise you that. I'm living proof of that. I have lived an amazing life. And though I was supposed to be a nobody and a worthless bum and a lifetime criminal, I guess, I've been so blessed. Those in the church community that were throwing stones at me, and some still do. How many people have you saved? How many strangers that you never even met have reached out to you over social media or by phone, and you let them in a sinner's prayer? How many times have you got up from your table in a public place and went and prayed with a total stranger just because the good Lord put it on your heart? And when you find out those people's story, you really needed some prayer at that moment. I'm certainly not claiming sainthood, because I'm damn sure a long way from it. But kind of like that Cody Jinks song, "I'm not the devil you think I am." And I'm a big fan of that song and the song, "I Cast No Stones." I mean, I've been playing in my head quite a bit here lately. But I've been invited to speak at churches all over this country. And it's an honor. Definitely an honor. And even though I'm a complete heathen, I've spoken through thousands. God's work. And I'm so blessed to do so. And through things like that, I met a lot of amazing people. Through the cowboy church circles, did a 3-day revival that I set up with world champion bull rider Ted News and an amazing pastor, John Riggs, and super talented, wonderful godly man, Jeff Gore, and my son Stillman, who's with me for that. We've been blessed to do some amazing things through Cowboy Ministry. And I used to be a lot more involved in it than I have been in the past few years. But with that said, all the naysayers then and now, there's a lot of people who don't really know a lot about my story in that department. And I won't go any further into it. But back to the underdog thing, I learned such an important lesson from a $200 Mustang that was kind of the Frankenstein version of horse flesh. He had a lot of parts that didn't match the other parts, and back as long as a polygamous clothesline, and He was old style Mustang. Confirmation was less than perfect, let's just say that. And it was a gut thing. I randomly met some, well, not randomly, because I don't believe anything's random. It's God designed. I met some people at a cowboy race type event here in Texas when I first moved down here. Became friends with them on social media, and shortly after that, heard the dad got hurt pretty bad. And when I called to check on him, they told me that he was busted up pretty good. And I kind of followed up on that. When he got out of the hospital and was home, I called him to check on him, and he was talking about ridiculous amounts of medical bills and more coming. And then he mentioned that he had a horse from the Mustang Million. And God bless him, he's not a horseman, he's not a horse trainer. His daughter's a heck of a little man, but she was just a kid then, and she'd gotten a horse for lead line stuff at the Million, and so he wanted to be a good dad and got a horse to play along. And I was flat broke because when I first moved to Texas, my hat was too flat and rope too long to get very much business down here at that point. And we were broke. I was as broke as I've been as an adult. Instantly, the Holy Spirit was telling me, you gotta ride that horse. So I'm having an argument with myself, saying, I'm broke. I don't even know where I'm getting gas money or food money next week. I can't do that. And I just kept getting pushed. You've got to ride this horse. So I told him, I said, I know you guys don't know me very well, but I won't charge you a dime. I'll ride that horse for you and see if I can win you some money. So, there's more details to the story. It took some doing just to go get the horse. And I put the 23rd ride of that horse's life on him at Fort Worth. And all I asked that horse to do was just soften his chin and stay between my hands and my legs. I said, that's all I can ask anybody. And my smallest class had 49 in it and was a dressage, and I'd never ridden a dressage pattern. I don't want to check. And then I went into the Coliseum there for the freestyle with no plan, no costume, no props, just listening to Marty Robbins, the Master's Call. And I just made stuff up as I was out there riding around, and that horse gave me things that just blew my mind. He couldn't stop to save himself, and he laid out 11s on every stop, and I'm just out there making stuff up, and I knew the song was getting close to ending, so I'm like, I gotta figure out how to end this, so I kind of cut across diagonal. Got to the center of the pen, said, whoa, he slid again. I turned him around. The last stop of the spin was the last note of that song. I couldn't do that again in a million tries. It was completely a God thing. And I've won a lot of world titles and big events. And I had never left the pen in tears. But I did that night. And by the time I hit them tunnels, out of the arena there at Fort Worth, I had tears streaming down my face. And I won fourth in that, and fourth in the cowwork the next day, and then reserve champ and reigning, and reserve champ and ranch trail, and won just barely under $10,000 on a $200 Mustang with less than 30 rides. That's more money than I've ever won at one event on any quarter horse. And it taught me such a great lesson about being an underdog. I guess that's why I have such a deep love for that horse, because, and I was, by the way, that was the first time I'd ever been in Fort Worth. I've never ridden there before. And I come in there, I'm known as an underdog. He was definitely an underdog. But everybody there remembers us. And remembers him, God bless him. And it was an amazing life lesson that just because he wasn't built for it, and just because he wasn't bred for it, boy, did he perform his heart out. And all I ask him to do is stay with me. That's all you got to do. Just stay soft in your face and stay between my reins and my legs. That's all you got to do, buddy. And I carry that lesson with me. I will forever. That was the most important ride of my life. Not a $200 Mustang. And so for those of you who, whether it's your job, your relationships, school, sports of any kind, it's okay to be an underdog. They'll never see you come. Occasionally I think of, matter of fact, I was having a really good conversation one evening in New York with a young lady that had attended my clinic, and she's been through quite a lot in her life. And so we were talking about the Lord and life and struggles and tragedy, just flat out tragedy, and loss, a lot of loss. And I'm not saying this to sound boastful, but for all those people who didn't believe me, who talked crap about me and still do to this very day, and said I'd be nothing, and that I'd be in prison by the time I was 19, I wonder how many of them are wearing a sponsored shirt. Thanks, Ag Gear. But, you know, because of horses and the good Lord, I have been all over this world pretty much and still going to new places. And, you know, I wonder how many of them have, you know, got piles of buckles and 11 of them that say they're the world champion at anything, or how many of them have been in a cast in a movie, or ridden their horse through Central Park, New York City, or in the surf of Southern California, literally watched dolphins play off the back of their horse. You know, I'm okay with being a worthless cowboy, really saddle tramp. I'm all right with that. The people I've met, I've sat out in cow camps with some of the most pure-hearted, wonderful human beings on this planet, and I have sat at dinner tables with multi-millionaires that were just incredibly fine people, and it's all a blessing. It's all a blessing. God, and it's because I never let other people's opinion shut me down, and I see it so much in my clinics all the time, that the people are filled with doubt because the professionals told them they couldn't, their horse couldn't. The only limitations that you have, right there. And it's not easy. It's not easy. But it is damn sure worth it. And, you know, if you, like I started to say, when when you have a passion burning inside you, God put that there. And if you trust Him, stay between your hands. He will reveal your greatness. And maybe that's just being a better human being, you know? Maybe you've been grown up in a home full of hard-nosed, rigid, nasty son of a bucks. And you're supposed to be just like them, but you got it in your heart to just be kind and be generous and be better. Do that. Be yourself. Be bold enough to be yourself. Folks, I say it all the time. I say it every damn day, I think. This ain't dress rehearsal. This is a one-time deal. You get to do this once. And if you aren't living the life you want to live, and you're not living your purpose and the dreams that God put inside you, it's up to the man in the mirror to change that. Or the woman in the mirror. But don't let the naysayers and the negatives pull you down. Keep looking up. Have faith in yourself. You good Lord. Spend time with as many right-thinking people as you possibly can. And, you know, if there's anybody out there that wants to call me up, tell me their story, maybe I can give you some advice. If nothing else, I could sure listen. I'm dang sure pray with you if that's what you need. And, like I say, I'm far from perfect. I'm a sinning man, sinning wretch. But guess what? There's a whole bunch of sin in every one of you, too. So that's why the good Lord hung on that cross, is because at the end of the day, He knows that we're all a bunch of sinning schmucks. Even you who are sitting on that church pew every Sunday and casting your stones at folks. Got some sin in you. Fortunately, He died for you just like He died for me. And you don't see bank accounts, trackers. He sees your heart. That's what matters most. So, friends, if you get to doubting things, do some praying, and like I say, you know how to message me on this thing, and you need my phone number, you just ask me for it, I'll give it to you, I'll talk to you until the roosters are crowing, I don't care. It's just kind of who I am. But enjoy your place of being an underdog. Give up. Underdogs are my favorite. I've been one my whole life. I've been an underdog my whole life. You know what? I'm pretty okay with that. I'm very okay with that. And you should be too. Believe in yourself. Rise above what others say. What others think, even those closest to you who somehow misjudge your intentions or your actions, or believe lies spoken either by other people or the devil himself. It's hard to understand why and how people that can be that close to you can kind of cut your throat and walk away like it don't matter. But, it comes to a point you just got to say, well, that's on them. Just keep praying for them and loving on them. That's all you can do, because that's what God called us to do, you know, is forgive them and pray for them and try to keep loving them. And that's Christianity in a nutshell right there. So hang in there. It's worth it. Don't give up. Because God equipped you. I can promise you that. And don't drag your past crap into tomorrow with you. It serves you no good purpose. It's in the past. Learn from your mistakes and move on. Lord knows I've made a million of them. I'm going to make a million more. And, but I'll never quit trying to get better. Be a better father, be a better horseman, just be a better human being in general. Just keep trying. Don't give up. Because all we need is about that much belief within ourselves. God, I hope somebody sends somebody to you that believes in you if you're doubting yourself. And I guess that's why I really had to put on my heart to do this video tonight. That hopefully it lands on ears that really needed it. You know, because I don't care who you are or what you're doing. I don't even know if I know your name. I believe in you. Because I don't put limitations on anyone. You ask anybody that's ever ridden with me at clinics, I don't put any limitations on a horse either. The only limitations that are on horses are the ones who are handling them right. They put limitations on them. I don't. I open doors wide open and say, hey, I believe in you. Let's see what you can do. And I'll do the same with people. I believe in you. Little belief goes an awful long way. Ask a boy who knows. I've had a rare few truly believe in me. But I guess that's why I love that song, and I posted it here not long ago. I can't remember the gal's name. It's a Christian song. He knows my name. If you're an underdog and people are trying to pull you down instead of lift you up, look up that song, He Knows My Name. Let those words sink in. Because boy, they mean a bunch to me. I've listened to that song a lot. And a lot here, well, He Knows My Name. And just hang in there. Don't quit. And for Corey Whitworth, brother, I really enjoyed the visit tonight. And for you sharing how you viewed me over all these years, man, it meant a lot to me. I had no idea. And got to the old feelings, buddy. I love you, brother. Anyway, guys, I better shut up. But again, if anybody needs a word, needs a prayer, just needs to talk, needs a laugh, I'm always good for a laugh. You can give me a holler anytime, day or night. I mean that from the bottom of my heart, whether I've ever met you or not. If you need somebody to talk to, I'm right here, because we need a little bit more of that. You know, we need a whole hell of a lot more of that in this world today. And hang with those who believe in you, who want to lift you up instead of drag you away from the things God put in front of you and the things God put in your heart. They're there for a reason. So, Christian up, cowboy up, cowgirl up. Stay focused on your dream. You got a purpose in this life. Don't let anything get in the way. Go live it. I got a lot of people in my personal life right now that think I've completely lost my mind with what I'm up to these days. But you know what? God put it on my heart. And it's not easy. But I'm about 99.9% sure that if God hadn't laid this on me, I wouldn't be doing it. So, anyway, friends, God bless you all.